Welcome back to Sugar Mama TV. I am Canna Campbell. I hope that you are safe. I hope that you are well, no matter where you are in the world right now. Today, I have a really exciting video for you. It's a capsule wardrobe video. You see, I really like to incorporate a minimalistic philosophy in my life, into all different components of my life, my social life, my food choices, and the way I choose to shop. You see, personally, I don't like to own lots of clothes because when I do this, all the clothes get squished together. They get damaged, they get crumpled, then I have to spend time ironing them or steaming them. Also, if they're all squished together in a wardrobe, I can't see them and therefore I don't wear them. And to me, that is a massive waste of money because as you know from watching my channel, I'm all about reducing and eliminating financial stress in our lives and using money in a more mindful way. So for this video today, I want to share with you some of the key items in my wardrobe that have allowed me as a minimalist to maximize my wardrobe to get and create as many outfits as possible without having to own lots of outfits. Now, today's video is proudly sponsored by and a collaboration with Lily Silk. I personally own a few key items from Lily Silk. They're really good quality, they're really reasonably priced, and they're classic pieces. They breathe beautifully and they work with so many key items in my wardrobe to allow me to maximize my wardrobe. So thank you, Lily Silk, for sponsoring this video today. Now, of course, I'm going to link in the video description box below all the items that I'm wearing so you know how to locate them yourself and do your own research. But of course, follow my money mantra and only buy what you love, value, use, and appreciate. All right, let's get started. These are the five key rules that I follow when it comes to putting together my outfits and the things I think about before I purchase anything. All right, the first rule is color palette. What is your color palette? What are the key colors that you find yourself being gravitated towards? When you walk into a shop and you've got lots of colors all over the room, what color draws you in? What makes you walk towards it? It's really worth your time investing some time on your own to really experiment and explore what colors are important to you, what colors you really like. And when you do this, there are so many amazing benefits that come from doing this. First of all, you'll find that you don't have as many regretful, wasteful purchases. You really get a lot of pleasure and enjoyment when you buy something because you're wearing it and it's working for you. And you don't feel that need to head back to the stores or jump online again and buy more. You have that perfect, adequate sufficiency. You know, when you go to a restaurant and eat the right amount of food, the right healthy food, you don't need to go and stuff your face with dessert and ice cream because you've got adequate sufficiency. That's what we want to aim to do when we do go shopping. Also, one of the best things that I personally love about having a great understanding about my color palette is in the morning when I've got one child doing this and the other child doing that and dogs doing this and I've got brain fog, I'm slow to get out the door, I can literally go to my wardrobe and go close my eyes, grab this, grab that, and voila, they're perfectly put together because they complement each other. The colors work and I can quickly and easily get dressed with minimal brain effort and get out the door. So stop and spend some time exploring what color palette you really love. Now, for me personally, I stick to the safe ones. I stick to the basics, the neutrals, the grays, the blacks, the beiges, the creams, the whites. That's what makes me feel pretty. That's what makes me feel like my skin glows, my hair glows. It accentuates my natural features. But then my satellite color, which is my, like, I guess I break it up, and that is pastels. I love a beautiful pastel blue, a beautiful pastel pink. That's what makes me feel happy, feminine, clean, and shine. So spend time learning about your color palette and stick to it. Rule number two is quality. Always quality. I have said goodbye to fast fashion. And trust me, this has been hard because there are sometimes great pieces, but there is no point buying something if it doesn't last. Think about how the item is going to wash. Does it need to be dry cleaned? How long is this item going to work in your wardrobe? I can't stress how important this is. And if you're on a tight budget and you agree with me on quality, consider the pre-loved economy. Now, quality doesn't necessarily need to cost a fortune as well. As you know from my other videos where I've shown and shared with you Lily Silk and the feedback you've given me from Lily Silk is they're really reasonably priced and they're beautifully made. The other thing I want to point out about quality is you need to take care of your items. Just because it's well made doesn't mean you don't have to care for it as much. Make sure at nighttime you fold your items up and put them away neatly. You will see in this video, some of the belts that I own in this are, I'm going to show my age in a second, but there's one belt in particular, which is over 15 years old, and the other belt is probably about 8 or 9 years old. Also, a couple of my handbags in this video are also pre-loved, but make sure you take care and pride and respect your items so that they remain good quality and they will last a distance. Because remember, I don't want you wasting your hard-earned precious money. And when we don't waste our money, we have more money left over for more investing and saving. Rule number three, accessorize. You can have so much fun playing up with your accessories. And this is probably one area in your life where you can potentially invest in a little bit more to have a wider range of accessories because they don't tend to take up that much space in your wardrobe. So spend time playing around with accessories. Play around with jewelry, layer jewelry, switch things up, change things around. Think about using jewelry in different ways. For example, in this video, you will see, and this is also, by the way, on my IGTV account, you will see that I've taken a long necklace and actually, instead of wearing it as a necklace, I've actually wrapped it around my wrist numerous times and turned it into a statement cuff. You don't necessarily have to wear jewelry in the way that we've been traditionally told. You can mix up your earrings. You can have one earring that's a stud, the other earring is a hoop, whatever you like. Have fun and play around with your accessories. It's a fantastic way to dress up and dress down your outfit so you get a really versatile wardrobe. Tip number four, and that is creative play. When your children are asleep at night or your partner's out or you're just hanging out at home alone, play in your wardrobe. Experiment with different looks. Try and button things up in different ways. Roll up the sleeves, roll the sleeves down, tuck in one side, tuck in all the sides, tuck it all out. Have an experimental time where you get really creative and put together a whole range of different outfits. And if you want to take it one step further and be even more organized, start taking photographs of outfits that you put together and think, oh wow, I never really thought about that. This looks really cool. This is actually what I did in creating this particular video. And I realized, actually, it's amazing the wide range of outfits that we can put together with the stuff that we already own. So often we don't necessarily need to go out and buy more stuff and new stuff all the time. Just simply get all the items out of your wardrobe, put them on the bed in front of you so you can see everything, touch everything, and get creative. Why don't you even do like blindfold and just grab two items and put them together? You never know what you are going to create, and you will find a much greater sense of gratitude and appreciation for all the items you already own. And of course, in doing this, it allows you to work out the gaps in your wardrobe, things that you could do with that will help bring together the final touches of an outfit. So have fun playing around. And then the fifth rule, which is probably the hardest rule that I find following, and that is shopping for your true lifestyle, not your fantasy lifestyle. I would love to just constantly buy beautiful, structured dresses. However, my lifestyle evolves less and less being in a beautiful, structured dress. And when I am, those events, especially because of COVID, are less and less. So for me, it would be an absolute waste of money. Continuously buy beautiful, structured dresses because they're not going to see the light of day. And I already have enough to get me through for a very long time. So stop and spend some time being honest with yourself. What does your wardrobe and your lifestyle really look like? For me, my lifestyle at the moment is running the kids to school, walking the dogs and the kids in the park, running to the office, and a lot of my office meetings now are on Zoom and Skype, so I don't necessarily need to be completely dressed up. I just need to wear a smart top to work and maybe some jeans or a skirt underneath. Really stop and spend time thinking about your wardrobe and what you need to be wearing. As I said, it's a waste of money to go and buy the clothing for your fantasy life. Look at your real life. And included for me is obviously having more active wear now that I'm getting back on top of my exercise routine again. And finally, of course, when it comes to shopping for your lifestyle, no matter what, always make sure whatever you buy is incredibly comfortable. If it's not comfortable, you're not going to wear it. So everyone, thank you so much for watching. Make sure you go and check out the Lily Silk website. They have very kindly and generously given me a code to pass on to you to get a great discount off these key items that I'm sharing with you. And of course, you can use that same code for a whole range of other items on their website. So thank you, Lily Silk, for sponsoring this video. And of course, everyone, make sure you follow my money mantra. Only buy what you love, value, use, and appreciate.